नमस्ते टू ऑल स्टूडेंट्स, खुश रहो बिटिया। माई सेल्फ जेवी एंड डॉक्टर खुशबू वर्मा, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द वेस्टर्न ब्लॉटिंग। दिस सेशन इज रिलेटेड टू रिकॉम्बिनेंट डीएनए टेक्नोलॉजी कोर्स ऑफ प्रोग्राम बीटेक एफबीटी एंड बीएससी बीटी सिक्स्थ ट्रेमेस्टर। वॉट इज वेस्टर्न ब्लॉट और इम्यूनो ब्लॉट? अ टेक्निक फॉर डिटेक्टिंग स्पेसिफिक प्रोटीन्स सेपरेटेड बाय इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस बाय यूज ऑफ लेबल्ड एंटीबॉडीज is known as Western blotting. In the procedure, these steps can be followed during the Western blotting process. First is tissue preparation, then electrophoresis, gel electrophoresis, then transfer, then blocking and detection, and then analysis. First of all, we will go for the tissue preparation. So samples may be taken from whole tissue or from cell culture. In most cases, solid tissues are first broken down mechanically using a blender. It should be noted that bacteria, virus, or environmental samples can be the source of protein, and thus Western blotting is not restricted to cellular studies only. Assorted detergents, salt, and buffers may be employed to encourage lysis of cell and to solubilize proteins. Tissue preparation is often done at cool temperature to avoid protein denaturing. In the next step, we will go for the gel electrophoresis. The proteins of the samples are separated using gel electrophoresis. Separation of proteins may be by isoelectric point, molecular weight, electric charge, or a combination of these factors. Here is the gel electrophoresis where we go for the separation of proteins. Next step is transferring. In order to make the proteins accessible to antibody detection, they are moved from within the gel onto a membrane made of nitrocellulose or polyvinyl adenine difluoride, which is PVDF. The membrane is placed on the top of the gel and a stack of filter papers placed on the top of that. The entire stack is placed in a buffer solution which moves up the paper by capillary action, bringing the protein with it. Another method for transferring the protein is called electroblotting and uses an electric current to pull proteins from the gel into the PVDF or nitrocellulose membrane. Next step is blocking. The membrane has the ability to bind to proteins. In this case, both the target and antibodies are proteins, and so there could be some unwanted binding. Blocking of non-specific binding is achieved by placing the membrane in a dilute solution of protein, typically bovine serum albumin, which is BSA, with a minute percentage of detergent such as 20. The protein in the dilute solution attaches to the membrane in all places where the target proteins have not attached. Thus, when the antibody is added, there is no room on that membrane for it to attach other than on the binding site of the specific target protein. Next step is detection. There are two steps for the detection of the protein. First is with the help of primary antibody. After blocking a dilute solution of primary antibody, generally between 0.5 to 5 microgram per ml, is incubated with the membrane under gentle agitation. The solution is composed of buffered saline solution with a small percentage of detergent and sometimes with the powdered milk. The antibody solution and the membrane can be sealed and incubated together from anywhere from 30 minutes to overnight. Next step is secondary antibody. After rising the membrane to remove unbound primary antibody, the membrane is exposed to another antibody directed at a species specific portion of the primary antibody. Several secondary antibodies will bind to one primary antibody and enhance the signal. Next, we will go for the analysis. So, calorimetric detection, with the help of, we can go for the calorimetric detection. The calorimetric detection method depends on incubation of the Western blot with a substrate that reacts with the reporter enzyme, such as peroxidase. Next step is chemiluminescent detection. In this detection method, it depends on incubation of the Western blot with a subshell that will luminescent when exposed to the reporter on the secondary antibody. Radioactive detection is a third type of analysis process where radioactive labels do not require enzyme substrate but rather allow the placement of medical X-ray film directly against the Western blot, which develops as it is exposed to the label and creates dark regions which correspond to the protein bands of the interest. Now we will go for the applications of Western blot. The confirmatory HIV test employs a Western blot to detect anti-HIV antibody in human serum sample. Proteins from known HIV infected cells are separated and blotted on a membrane as a bond. Then the serum to be tested is applied in the primary antibody incubation step. Free antibody is washed away, and a secondary anti-human antibody linked to an enzyme signal is added. The stained band then incubate the proteins to which the patient's serum contains antibody. Western blot can also be used as a confirmatory test for hepatitis B infection. What are the disadvantages? So if a protein is degraded, and this test takes longer than other existing tests, it might also be more costly. So these are three disadvantages of Western blotting. And this session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Hope you are satisfied with this digital session. If you have any query, then mention in the comment box. I will resolve. Thank you.